I saw the churnings of a remarkable change at this point in time. The 14th Bahmani King Muhammad Shah's royal court is giving a warm welcome to Quli Qutb Shah from the Persian city of Hamdan. Quli Qutb Shah becomes a Subedar, an important military officer of the Bahmani Kingdom. Impressed by his working style and abilities, he is made Qutb ul-Mulk, or Governor of Telangana. Within 7 years, the estate of Golconda is handed over to him. Golconda etches a new signature on the pages of time. Bahmani rule ends. Quli Qutb Shah proclaims himself the Sultan of Golconda. I, Quli Qutb Shah, declare myself the Sultan of Subah Telangana. This sultanate will henceforth be known as Qutb Shahi Sultanate. Kilai Golconda will be our capital. With Sultan Quli Qutb ul-Mulk, the foundation of the Qutb Shahi Sultanate was laid in Telangana. Sultan Quli made Golconda his capital, beautified the fort, and named it Muhammad Nagar. Qutb Shahi sultans constructed many palaces, gardens, masjids, and many buildings for public use inside the fort in a properly planned way. Spread over a radius of 7 kilometers, the fort has 8 gates. Ahead of the entrance gate, Bala Hisar, is the Diwan-e-Khas and the court. Beyond that lies the Sultan's residence and the Queen's palace. Separate from this cluster lies the Mahakali Temple, where even now the popular Bonaru Jatra is organized with great fanfare every year. After Sultan Quli, his third son, Jamshed Quli Qutb Shah, became the Sultan. He had a long drawn out conflict with his younger brother, Ibrahim Quli, who had to take refuge under the Ram Rai of the Vijayanagar Empire. Jamshed Quli died after ruling for 7 years. Ibrahim came back from Vijayanagar and declared himself the king. A lake was constructed during his reign. The lake was named Hussein Sagar after his son-in-law and the renowned Sufi saint Hussein Shah Wali. Ibrahim Quli started the expansion of Golconda beyond Musi River, and his son Sultan Muhammad Quli completed this expansion. The Sultan had a deep-seated affection for Persian and Deccan literature and the Telugu language as well. He was the first ruler to patronize Telugu education in Golconda. Telugu poets Adanki Gangadhar Kavi, Kandukuri Rudra Kavi, and many other Telugu poets recited poems in his royal court. He appointed Adanki Gangadhar Kavi as the Telugu poet laureate of his court. In Telugu literature, Sultan Ibrahim is known as Maliki Bharam. Renowned Telugu writer Kandukuri Rudra Kavi was awakening the conscience of society through his writings. By writing Yakshagana simultaneously in prose and play formats, he gained such eminence that Sultan Ibrahim Kuri Qutub Shah desired to hear his rendition in person. Ibrahim Kuri was blessed with a son named Muhammad Kuri. In his young years, Muhammad Kuri met Bhagmati of Chincharam village, which is across the Musi River. Both of them fell deeply in love. His father Ibrahim Kuri realized that for the betterment of the Sultanate, he should not oppose their union. So Bhagmati and Muhammad Kuri were united forever.